And then there were 5. After 12 episodes, 20 something days, and 13 players down, we're at the final 5.
Top 5, yeah! Top 5, baby! Top 5, baby! Top
yeah!
Yeah! It's been an eventful merge, even though it looked like a Reba pagonging at some point. In the end, however, even the Reba 4 had to cannibalize each other. In less than a week, we're crowning the winner of Survivor 45. No better time to rank our final 5 contenders. Who's in the best and worst spot going into the finale? With only 5 players left, we can dive in a bit deeper into their games. Who has played well and is a favorite, and who has little to no chance to win, and why is that person Jake? Don't get me wrong, Jake is probably my most favorite player left in the game. It's been a blast seeing him bumble through the merge, but let's be honest, that's what he has been doing. Jake has the best intentions, but has he pulled off even one successful move? Ever since he tried to save Caleb, he's been playing catch-up to everyone else, and even now hasn't really caught up. Jake has great intentions and good ideas, but the execution just isn't there. Even now, with an idol in his pocket, I have no real faith he can pull off a redemption move. He seems well liked by the other players, but he lacks the respect to win the season. To me, Jake has played a game that many of us watching at home would play, even though we might think we would play a Tony Vlachos game, for example. However, Gabler has shown us that a Jake win is not completely impossible. He's a lock for the final 3, but a win? I highly doubt it. If any of the final 5 has had a purple edit, it's Keturah. The majority of her Survivor 45 journey has been determined by her feud with Bruce, probably to her own nightmare. I couldn't even tell you what she has played besides wanting Bruce gone. And even when Bruce got voted out, there was no real turning point for her game. She hasn't had any real agency so far. She's been used as a number for others to make a move. It's a shame, because her backstory is probably one of the most amazing stories I've ever heard on Survivor. She was so focused on Bruce that she forgot the bigger picture. After Bruce left, the intention was there, but it was too little too late. However, compared to Jake, she not only is well liked, but she also has the respect that Jake doesn't have from the jury. Keturah's problem is that this is still a final 3, meaning she's sitting next to at least one Reba, and every Reba member has played a better game than her, so I don't know how she wins at this point. Oh, how the mighty have fallen. Austin was in such a solid spot at the merge. In the core of the Reba 4 with 2 immunity idols and a ride or die in Drew. Where did it go wrong for Austin? Well, firstly, he gave away one of his island and never got it back? How the hell did that happen? How did we not see Austin asking for it and Julie not wanting to give it back? Julie having that idol allowed her not only to save herself, but to vote out Drew the week after. Austin would be in a totally different spot if he just got his idol back. The second reason Austin game has crumbled is love. Yes, we all love love, but in Survivor, it's just a nail in your coffin. I don't really care too much for showmances on Survivor, it's not why I watch this show. I'm sure Dee and Austin are great together, but you can't deny that the showmans hurt his game more than helped it. Deciding to tell Dee about the plan to vote out Julie was such a bad call. All the more painful when Dee does what Austin couldn't the week after. The only way I can see Austin winning is in a final 3 with Keturah and Jake. If he's sitting next to either Julie or Dee, he's cooked, because those women just played a better game than him. Honestly, there's very little difference between Julie and Dee. You could switch Julie for 1 and Dee for 2, and you would have a fair point. At the merge, Julie was in a solid spot but had little agency. She seemed like the least influential of the Reba Four. Until she got Austin's idol, that is. It's still a shame we didn't get to see how that happened. Seems like a instrumental point in Julie's game. If that doesn't happen, she is not able to save herself and can't get out two crucial players in Emily and Drew. Her game also seems very strongly respected by the other players, and that was before she was the main target for True Tribals, and she's still there. She has also proven herself to be a challenge beast despite being an older contestant. That's quite the pitch if she gets to the final three, and that's her biggest hurdle yet. D is her biggest threat. If she gets D out and gets to the final three, I believe she wins. However, she's also a very visual jury threat, so getting to the final three is not going to be easy for Julie. D is in the best position ahead of the final, and she made it happen in the latest episode. D has been a very consistent player throughout the season. She showed some impulsive, trigger-happy behavior initially, but she got through it. She was never really in any danger of going home throughout the game. The only thing she missed was a signature move, and she pulled that off by getting out Drew. Truthfully, it was a two-pronged move. By saving her ally Julie the week before, but still voting with Drew and Austin, she allowed herself to make the move against Drew the week after. Being put in the same spot as Austin, but making the decision to not tell him, is a cutthroat move that deserves a lot of respect. Those are the moves we watch Survivor for. Make the move and ask for forgiveness later. If D gets to the final three, I think she wins against whoever. Even though Julie might give her a run for her money, I believe D still played a better game because she saved Julie on two occasions. If D wins, she will truly be seen as the Parvati of the new era, and rightfully so. That's my power ranking for the final five ahead of the finale. A lot can still happen. Most notably, Jake's idol needs to drop. It could cut short either Julie or Dee's game if Jake plays it right. Then again, it is Jake, so no guarantees there.
Whoa!
After the final, I'll be back with a final postseason power ranking of all 18 players. 13 weeks, 18 players, 1 power ranking. Until next time.